Happy New Year, everyone, and welcome again to the Shyam Sharma Show. We are back with a brand new episode, and today we're going to be talking about the recent protests that were happening at Bhima Koregaon in Maharashtra, and I want to give you my thoughts and my opinions and my takeaway of this whole situation. So tell you what, guys, let's bring in the new year, and let's jump right into it. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to a brand new edition of the Shyam Sharma Show. Happy New Year to everyone watching. I hope you had a fantastic New Year celebration. And I, in fact, went back to India. I spent some time with my family. It was a great time. And I am back, refreshed, recharged, and ready to go. All right, so a lot of things have happened while I've been gone, so I want to try and cover all of them, or most of them, during the week. But today, I want to try and talk about something that happened over the past couple of days. And it's been creating a lot of noise in and around India for all the wrong reasons. And I want to clear some misconceptions, and I want to clear some confusion that I have in my head over this whole situation. So what's happened recently is there's a place called Bhima Koregaon in Maharashtra where there were some protests happening where some people were celebrating the defeat of the Peshwas at the hands of the British. And some clashes happened around this protest, and in fact, one person was killed. And apparently, according to a news report, he was targeted because he was wearing a jacket which had the face of Shivaji, who was the legendary Maratha king, embossed on his jacket. So first and foremost, right off the bat, when you think about this, it's very strange because you're celebrating the victory of the British over the Marathas. And many people say that, oh, these Peshwas who got defeated, they were Brahmins and they were very oppressive people. So it's a great thing that they were defeated. But at the same time, you're celebrating the victory of a country and a people who instituted the incredibly casty zamindari system, where they gave all of the power to the upper caste and allowed them to exploit the lower caste even more than was possible before. They constantly pitted community against community and divided India among caste and religious lines just to be able to rule. They murdered millions and millions of Indians through either direct action or through indirect policy. And they also created this incredibly stupid system of martial races, which was not created because these races or these communities were somehow inherently martial. They were just created because they could use these communities to then defeat and kill other communities which were offering a more obstinate defense of themselves against the British Empire. Now, let's also look at some other things about this whole protest and why people are celebrating this. People are celebrating this as some sort of a Dalit victory over the Peshwas and over the Marathas. But is it actually the case? The Marathas were not an all Brahmin army. Yes, the Peshwas were Brahmins, and a lot of the generals and commanders were most likely Brahmins, but a lot of the foot soldiers were people from the lower caste, and a lot of the foot soldiers and some commanders were also Muslims. And also, the British were not an all Mahar force anyway. The British had a large number of Mahars fighting from them against the Peshwas, but they also consisted of many other Hindus, and they also consisted of many Muslims. And another very important thing to note here is that none of these Mahars that were fighting for the British were in any kind of leadership or commanding positions. All of the commanding officers and all of the important officers were all white European British people. So if we're drawing stupid conclusions about, you know, this battle, and if we're drawing stupid conclusions about, oh, this is a great Dalit victory against the evil Brahmins, then we can also draw other stupid conclusions. Like, this is actually the people celebrating this, they're celebrating the murder of many Muslims at the hands of Dalit. Is that true? No. But if we're drawing stupid conclusions, then we can draw this stupid conclusion too. We can draw yet another stupid conclusion that the Mahars are actually completely incapable of leadership on their own and being able to lead their people. So they actually need these white British or the Brahmins to lead them. Now, is that true as well? Absolutely not. Any person from lower caste or any person from any caste in India is completely capable of leadership. It is not designed by birth in any way. Narendra Modi is a great example of that. But again, if we're drawing stupid conclusions, then we can draw this stupid conclusion too. Now, here's the thing. The protest is not a problem. You know, if there's a small group of people who want to protest once a year in a small way, you know, one and done, where they want to inculcate some sense of pride in that they have some accomplishments and achievements, that's fine. It's a free country. Do what you need to do. The problem is the likes of Jignesh Mevani, is the likes of the Congress Party, is the likes of Umar Khalid, hijacking this protest to then create further divisions within Indian society. Now, we know very well the Congress's agenda. They have ruled India for 60 years out of the 70 years that India has been independent. They follow the same British system of divide and rule. Do what you need to do to divide people in order to maintain your power and hold on to that power. They've done that for 60 years very successfully. It's only now that we've been able to break free from the shackles of the Congress party. So let's not make that mistake of falling into that same Congress trap again. And having said that, I also want to point out that there are serious problems when it comes to caste in India. You know, I'm from Bihar, and there these caste divisions are even more raw and even more painful, because for the past few decades there have been political leaders that have exploited these divisions to great effect and create further divisions within Bihari society to be able to maintain and hold on to power. People like Nitish Kumar, people like Lalu Yadav, people like Ram Vilas Paswan, they've done this very, very well. And there is a problem. Like me coming from a Brahmin family myself, I've seen that the generation just above me, how they have behaved or talked about certain people from different castes, the generation above them, that problem was even more acute. So yes, of course, there is a long way to go to fix the relationship between different castes in India. And some people from the upper caste need to let go of this stupid mentality that just because you were born in some family, that makes you better than some other person that was born in some other family, purely out of chance. Having said that, though, there have been improvements in my generation. And this is what I want to ask people. Do people really see this as the way forward? To associate themselves with people who have worked tirelessly to create divisions in Indian society, who have worked tirelessly to divide India among caste and religious lines. Do they really want to associate themselves with such people? Do they really want to associate themselves with the likes of Mr. Umar Khalid, who is the son of an ex-Simi leader, a banned outfit in India, who was chanting for the breaking of India into different pieces? Does the Dalit movement really want support from this ugly Communist-Islamist nexus? Do they really want support from the Congress party? The Congress party, which has been power, like I said before, for 60 years, if they really had the well-being and the benefit of the Dalits at their heart, wouldn't you think that the Dalits would be in a much better social, economic, and political position than they are today? Because 60 years is a long time. The truth is that they don't want Dalits to be educated so that they can make their own decisions. They want Dalits to be poor and angry. Poor and angry people can be controlled really well, because they will always be told that all your problems are because of those evil Brahmins. So vote against those Brahmins and vote for us, because we'll take care of you. Coming back to that Islamist communist nexus, do they really want support from that communist nexus? Because anywhere where this nexus is present in any kind of strong numbers around the world, they always work to destroy the indigenous structure or the indigenous culture of that country. When the original culture is dead, then the communists and the Islamists fight each other to death to see who reigns supreme. Let's just look at Pakistan as an example. Look at the state of the East Pakistanis in Pakistan. They had no rights. Millions of them were murdered, and all of them were always treated like garbage by the West Pakistanis, who, by the way, had all the power. So is that the future they want? Myself, personally, I believe they don't. I believe that a lot of the people who do this protest and a lot of the people who do the celebration in a small, muted way, they're just doing because they want to inculcate a sense of pride in their community, and they just want faster reformation. They actually don't want the dismantling of India and the dismantling of India's indigenous culture, because they value it, even though they see that there's some clear problems with it. But the problem is that associating with people like Umar Khalid, like Jignesh Mewani, like the Congress party, and affiliating themselves with them is a dangerous thing to do. So it's important that these people shun these so-called leaders. It's important that we as a society and as a country shun these leaders and call out their true motives, and that the best way forward is reformation and reconciliation rather than destroying our indigenous system, because it is rich and because this system is what has helped maintain our culture in a large way against the Muslim and Christian onslaught. So that's my takeaway from it. I want to know what you think. I would love to hear your thoughts on this matter. Do you think that This is a good protest, or do you think that this is an insidious protest? Do you think that all of these people associating themselves with this protest are doing it from the goodness of their heart, or do they have ulterior motives? Please let me know what you think. Please get involved in the comment section below and let me know. I would love to hear your opinions. Also, I've mentioned this before, but I'm also looking to work on a series where I talk to some people from the right, get to know their opinions, and then broadcast their perspectives, their opinions on my show, give them a platform here, and share it with whatever small audience I have. Hopefully, I'm looking to get that started and done by end of this month. So if you have any people that you think would be great candidates to appear and for me to go reach out to them and talk to them and interview them, please let me know either in the comments below or in my Twitter right here. And I would love to reach out to them as well. All right, and that's the show. Thank you very much for watching today's show. Thank you very much for tuning in and joining me. I appreciate you. I am most likely going to be back tomorrow with a brand spanking new edition of the Sham Sharma Show. So make sure that if you're not subscribed to the channel yet, subscribe. Alrighty, I will see you tomorrow. And until then, Happy New Year. Stay happy, stay healthy, and I'll see you soon.